Hello all. In this video I'll be showing you how an assembly of eccentricity is done. As I have explained you how to design individual components of an eccentricity in the previous video lectures of mine. Now for this video I'm going to select an assembly module. I'll say OK. Now the tools which you could see all are related to assemblies. Okay, where you can insert your component, you can coincident, you align your component, you can maintain certain distance with respect to your components. Okay, that we are going to see now. Now, as I have developed all the components individually according to the dimensions in my previous video lectures, which I have posted. Now, we'll assemble them all. Let us start the session. I'll just insert the component. I'll take one of the strap which we have designed before. I'll try to position here. Yeah, I'll place it here, rotate it with respect to Y. Then insert one more component. This time I'm going to take a sheave as the component. I'll try to place it here near to the part number one. I'll rotate and I'll try to take an option called mate. With this option you can coincident, maintain parallelism, perpendicularity. All these options can be performed. Okay, as of now I'm going to select the top surface of sheave going to be aligned with the internal surface of the strap. This is one proper alignment, and this external surface of sheave should be in contact with the internal surface of strap. Done. Okay, this is properly fixed. Now have a look at it. Next, let us insert one more component. The name of the component, let me take packing material. I'll place it near by and let me take mate option. I'll try to align the circular hole of packing material with the strap circular hole. This is done, properly fixed. Have a look at it. Check it out by zooming in. One more similar material, packing material, bring onto the screen, because to the other side also we need to fix that particular packing material. Let me rotate with respect to Z axis and mate the circular hole of packing material with the strap number one. This is fine. Yes, properly aligned. Let me bring one more component. The name of the component is again a strap number two. I named it as strap two. Let me rotate with respect to Y. Yes, this is actual position it need to be. So I'll place it nearby and I'll take mate option to coincide this circular hole with the done. Have a look once whether it is aligned properly above and below or not, because sometimes what happens, only one side it is going to align, other side may get rotated upside, so that you need to check it out. Once this is done, to intact these two, to align these two, what we need to do, we need to take a strap bolt and fix those two together. I'll consider one strap bolt and rotating with respect to what it has to take its horizontal position. Yes, yeah, this is fine. I'll place it nearby and with respect to mate option. Now what I could do here is this surface outer of strap bolt should be in contact or alignment with the internal hole of the strap. This is one setup I made. Further, this surface of the head of strap bolt should be in contact with the strap surface, that is done. Yes, it is. So same, one more need to be fixed to the other side, that I do by bringing back the same component, strap bolt. Let me rotate. Yes, I'll place it nearby. By considering this mate option, I can align the outer surface of strap bolt should be aligned with the internal surface of the straps, followed by next step is the head outer should be in contact with the strap. Done. In few cases we need to go through 2-3 conditions. Okay, whereas while placing packing material it has taken only a single step, whereas in case of strap bolt it has taken 2 different steps. That is important. And to intact these two, to tighten those two straps together, placing in between a packing material, I need to bring a nut onto the assembly module. This is the nut, and I'll just try to place it nearby. And by taking mate option similar to the before one, the internal hole should be in contact with the external stud. This is one setup I made parallelly. This surface of hexagonal nut should be in contact with the strap. Oh, sorry, it went wrong. Let me take once again material alignment. This surface should be in contact with this surface. Yes, it is done properly. Let me bring the same nut once again onto the screen of assembly, and I'm repeating the option again. The internal should be aligned with the external of the strap bolt. This is one. Next one, this should be in contact with the strap. Number two, have a look. Now there is no scope that sheave can be taken out, or else strap packing material can be taken out. This is how this got intacted. Okay, now the remaining one is eccentric rod, which we have designed already in part drawing. Now this is the rod I was talking about, and let me take mate option. This outer surface should be aligned with this one. This is fine. I'll show you what is alignment. Both are maintaining proper distances. Okay, there is no contact actually, but still you feel that both are in contact with each other when I keep it in a certain view. Okay, this is what alignment is all about, but actually it is not aligned. If I rotate, have a look at it, these are maintaining some offset distance. Okay, that is more important. Other than that, this hole should be, sorry, this one, this is fine. Now everything is done perfectly. Let me bring the screw, because eccentric rod should be in contact with the strap number two properly. So a screw already designed should be retrieved. Then again, in a similar fashion, the way we did for other external screw surface should be aligned with the internal hole, then followed by the surface of screw head, hexagonal head should be in contact with this particular strap number two, sorry, eccentric rod. That is fine. In a similar fashion, I'll try to bring one more time screw onto the screen, because I haven't developed too many screws. So only one screw is there of same specification, so that can be used multiple times, not a problem. No need to prepare or design again and again. Okay, that is a goodness of using modeling softwares. Now everything is perfectly sitting in its working position. Assembly is nothing but aligning or mating all the surfaces or all the components with in its working position. Now all are positioned in its own way. Have a look at it. This is the working position of each and every component, and let me keep it in one view. this is the assembly of eccentricity. Have a look at the wireframe model. This is what we'll draw actually in actual practice for your class work. Okay, now the things which are completely invisible are kept in a hidden line, dashed line. This edge, this circular one, this one, and the screw clamps, all these things kept in invisible, which are visible made completely dark. Okay, this is how we do. If you take the same component onto the draft sheet, then there you could see the top view, every other views of this particular component. One more interesting point of this particular assembly is, if you want to change the colors, because all are maintaining same colors here on the in the assembly, if you want to make changes of the those components, that is going to reflect here on the screen. That is the goodness of or the richness of using this particular softwares. That is the main one more advantage, I would say. Let me take a new file, power drawing. I'll just try to make few changes in the colors so that you could see them on the screen. Let me open. Let me take a sheave. I'll take this sheave material and let us add some color to it. Or else actual metal colors can also be given. I'll go to appearances, plastic, metals. I'll just go to metals and let me give a color of polished bronze. Okay, let me save this particular model. Or else you can give normal colors also, like blue, green, red, anything is fine. But as of now we are dealing with proper assembly, so if you could give metal colors, that will always be better. Fine, let me change other colors also. Other colors like file, open. I'll go with some eccentric rod. Let me change this color. I'm not going to change all, just for your understanding I'm going to change few. Let me give some metal color, bronze, copper, nickel, iron. Let me give some dark. Now when I selected iron color, it has taken dark black. Let it be, and let me save. Once you make any changes, whether it is a color change or a feature change or a sketch change, that has to be saved. Unless you save it, that is not going to reflect on this particular module or an assembly. Alright, this is how you could do. This is how an assembly look like. Okay, in between two strap there is a packing material. Let me change that color, then everything looks fine with that. Let me change that color. File, open. That is packing material. Let me take this packing material. Yeah, this is the component followed by, let me give some different alloy color, aluminium, magnesium. Fine, lead. No, there should be some contrast. Let me give some gold color so that it might look somewhat different from other. So let me save and go to assembly module. There you could see. Similarly, all other components can also be maintained. Okay, this is what I would like to show you. This is more and more important assembly, where students will get confused actually in presenting it on a sheet of paper. But if you could understand three-dimensional components according to its dimensions and assemblies according to its dimensions properly, and its working positions actually, that will help you a lot. Okay, if you forget to, while drawing a sketch, if you forget to place this particular packing material, and if you join these two, that will go wrong, because these two are not going to take 360 degrees. There is a gap of 8 mm in between. Okay, if you try to match up those two together, then the in between sheave will shrink. If you think according to the physical contact of those component, then that is going to happen. Okay, well, this is all for this particular assembly, eccentricity, about appearances and all other. Thank you so much for watching. Please do share, subscribe. the channel. Thank you once again.